Dear students, we will see about continuation of computer-aided biopharmaceutical characterization. As we have seen in the last class, it is a continuation of the one. Now we'll see about virtual trial and feed versus fasted state of modeling, in vitro silico model and in vitro in vivo correlation, including the in vitro dissolution. Then last one is in behavior consideration with respect to examples. What are the some of the examples behavior considerations? Okay, coming to the first one, virtual trial. In the later stages of formulation development, it is especially valuable to anticipate inter-subject variability that may influence oral drug bioavailability. In this way, the formulator might gain a better insight on what can be achieved by means of formulation. In this aspect, in order to predict or to understand in silico simulation on the influence of population variability or combined effect of formulation variability that are relevant, which is not precise values, but which is to understand which distribution of the values can be estimated. That's what we want to know. No, the virtual trial features in GastroPlus can be used for using these kind of variable techniques. Okay, these features allows the users to perform stochastic simulation on number of virtual subjects, wherein the value of selected variables are random sample from predicted distribution, which is defined means of coefficient of variation. That is how much far it is relevant with respect to the absolute and log space. Now the variability may vary. We need to identify and we could be able to predict. That's what CV percentage are usually estimated on the basis of previous knowledge or analysis of literature data. The results of simulations are expressed as means and the coefficient of variation for a fraction of drug absorbed and bioavailability, Tmax, Cmax, and AUC. These are general pharmacokinetic parameters which we can be able to get it from animal studies, as well as the absolute minimum and maximum values of each of these parameters reached from the trials. That's what we will get it from practical value. Also, the average of time, no, curve, 90% confidence level, probability contours like 10, 20, 50, 70, 90, and 100%. We can be able to correlate the variables and experimental data with the possible bioequivalence limits, which is available or which can be displayed, can able to absolutely, we can able to obtain by using this particular GastroPlus model. Coming to the example for virtual trial means by generally, just for example, I'm telling you virtual trial in the sense to know the known data of earlier clinical data with an experimental data, how far it is given similar kind of effect, or how far exactly we could be able to predict the parameters we can be able to observe. No, or it can says about whether it is which kind of dependent results, whether it is a new result or earlier result or reported result, whether it is controversy, whether it is a new invention or similar results, anything we can be able to observe. No, that's what first example we can say about an illustration and use of virtual trials for in silico modeling of oral drug absorption can be seen. Some of the scientists have been done in 2006. We can see the example. The prime objective of the study was to demonstrate how an in silico approach can be used to predict a nonlinear dose dependent absorption property of telinolol. No, that is that drug to could able to see what is we are doing. We are doing a GastroPlus mathematical model or software to predict non-linear dose dependent absorption property. That is what it is, very, very important. This section will focus solely results of virtual trial simulation. The reason why the author preferred simulation of virtual trial mode was include the effect of physiological variables such as transit time. No, that's what we discussed before and all. Total out of 8 hours. No, how many hours it will be there for specific places. Various GI compartment model, GI pH, length and radii, or we can say pharmacokinetic parameter, plasma protein binding, renal clearance of telenol absorption. The stochastic variables were randomly selected within the range of defined by the means with the predetermined coefficients of variations in log normal space and used for the simulation. That's what we can say. The current value will be compared with an literature value. The simulation result revealed that of observed clinical data lay within the minimal and maximum individual patient simulations, suggested that that CV percentage values are used to the log normal distribution of stochastic variable, which produced variability that encompasses the observed clinical data. It means, like this example says, that current study data reveal the literature observed data. That's what whatever we could able to observe from this example. Then coming to the next one, pharmacokinetic model, which is used for feed and foster state. It is very, very important in terms of physiological or in terms of other parameters we could be able to identify. Okay. Then coming to the feed and fast aid, the presence of food may affect the drug absorption by a variety of mechanism by impacting GI tract physiology. Say something which is given in the slide, then don't think it is exactly only if you see fasted state means it will affect, feed state means it will affect. No, it may be contrast example. Feed state, some drug will have more absorption, and feed state, some drugs will not have any absorption, food will have interference. Same thing vice versa can happen in fasted state of drug absorption. That's what we can able to say. Just for the example to have an impact on presentation, we say that presence of food may affect drug absorption. You cannot say it is maybe either positive effect or negative effect. Example, that food induced changes of gastric emptying time, gastric pH, intestinal fluid composition, hepatic blood flow, drug solubility dissolution, and drug solubility and dissolution and drug permeation have been very clearly example we have done from 1996 by the Welling scientist. For an example, now coming to the was as I told you earlier, may have positive effect, negative effect, like that. When come to the property of the drug, we can able to say lipophilic drug often shown increased systematic exposure within food. No, lipophilic drug. No, the phenomenon attribute to improve solubilization due to the higher bile salts and lipid concentration. Say example, like azithromycin, any like azithromycin. Generally, they say, according to my knowledge, no, that aminoglycosides, antibiotic will give with, if you have more lipid drug, it will absorb more like that. No, negative food effect may mostly seen in hydrophilic drug where impedes the permeation. No, fact that physiological factors of species dependent and magnitude of food effect for a given compound across the species is usually different, thus complicating the prediction of food effect on humans also have been observed in 2006. Then you can say negative effect have been observed in 2007. One alternative to an animal experiment is to simulate a food effect of human using physiological based absorption model. Considering that these models are built based on the prior knowledge of GI physiology in the fasted and feed state, they are able to describe the kinetics of drug transit, dissolution, absorption on the basis of drug specific features such as permeability, bioirrelevant solubility, ionization constant, dose, metabolism and distribution data, etc. by using a GastroPlus. That's what it is, main advantage of using a software. No, like a default of physiological parameter, which differs from what you can say, fasted as well as fed state of conditions. No, when you are administering the drug, that physiological parameters also will vary, which was given in the table. You can able to see stomach pH. No, like very, very important. If you are fasting, exactly will be in acidic condition 1.2, relevant to 1.3 approximately. Fed means it will become slightly neutral. The stomach transit time, fasted means 25.5 hours. Fed means it is 1 hour. Usually we say 2 hour. Stomach volume is 50 ml. No, or if you say fed state, it is 1000 ml, 1 liter. The duodenum pH is 6. It slightly reduces 5.4. Jejunum pH, it is 6.2, 5.4. Then jejunum pH is 6.4 and 6. Then hepatic blood flow will be, if it is fasted, it will be acidic nature. If it is in food, it will be alkaline in, slightly, not alkaline, I told wrong. It is 1.5 pH to 2 pH. These observations, several studies, by using these above table observation, many studies have been conducted to correlate the predictions of GastroPlus using in silico pharmacokinetic model. The several studies have been confirmed the usefulness of in silico modeling approach to assess the food effect for an oral drug absorptions. For an example, Jones et al. 2006 incorporated bioirrelevant solubility and degradation data into the GastroPlus. The absorption model to the predicted plasma profiles in fed, fasted, or high or low fat conditions for 6 model compounds. There are many, some other compounds also they have been tested for the parameters of solubility degradation kinetics by using the things, by the parameter which is involved is plasma profiles in food condition, fasted condition, whether it is in high fat condition or low fat condition have been observed. That you can able to see that virtual data, that available control release profile, you can say like prediction, no? Weibull method, test, that there is a relative model, then test more. Checked with then test 1, test 2, it is in predicted 1, no, predicted 1, then test 1 is lower, it can be maybe similar. Here you can see like carbamazepine, I think so, this is a drug, like fasted state, then if you say fed state, it is same thing, carbamazepine maybe, you can see like it is a bit variation is there with the absorption. No, if you say with the fed condition, carbamazepine is reached faster than what you can say if faster state. No, the faster state took little more time to reach the peak, but when you have with the food, it is sharp, immediate peak have been observed. You can see this is 3000, reaches to 4000, it is below 3000. It says that by virtual, this particular example model by using GastroPlus, I think so, this is, we can say like carbamazepine could be able to see with the fed state, it could be able to increase the absorption of the drug. Then coming to the pharmacokinetic model, PBPK prediction strategy of oral absorption prediction, which is Parrot have been done in 2008. We can say compound specific data, mechanical absorption model, then comparison of in vivo model with the thing. I think last class also we have discussed about this. Then in vitro data, physicochemical data, and in vitro data. These are the relevant to the compound. then which can able to give you say in vitro physical data for animal model, in vitro physical data for the human model. Okay, when you are coming to the simulation and refinement, animal data will give you observed versus predicted. Then we can say with the simulation of absorption model with the comparative data. That's what we can be able to identify from in vitro and animal model, human model, and simulation, and final simulation model can give you exactly predict that how the drug can behave during the absorption. Coming to the in vitro dissolution and in vitro in vivo correlation, the two approach enhancing approaches are enabling the gastro plus, particularly very specifically we are giving only one, the drug specific absorption model to be used to assess relationship between in vitro and in vivo data. There are two type of methods are available. It is a convolution method, deconvolution method. Know that that convolution method is to predict very clearly it is given, it is in plasma concentration. Deconvolution method is estimate in vivo dissolution profile. There are a plasma concentration profile and to estimate in vivo dissolution profile. For this, even bioweaver justification should be discussed, whether the dissolution from dosage form is expected to be a rate limiting factor for drug in vivo absorption. This important factor, you need to understand the concept of in vitro in vivo correlation. Coming to the first approach, that is convolution approach, a set of in vitro data representing different dissolution scenarios is used to the input functions of GastroPlus software estimate expected drug plasma concentration drug profile. That's what I told you earlier. It is an determination. This one slide you could be able to observe and prepare for the exam. That predict the plasma concentration profile. Deconvolution will give you in vivo dissolution profile. Step two is obtained profile are compared with mean drug plasma concentration profile observed by in vivo in order to establish the in vitro in vivo correlation. The deconvolution approach, the GastroPlus is generated in vivo dissolution profile is plotted against the in vitro obtained dissolution profile so that the bio performance of dissolution condition can be identified. That's what we used to say. What is the nature of study can able to predict the model. That we can able to say like in vitro in vivo correlation statistical parameter of GLK, maybe some drug, and I think glycolacin, no? Yes, that's what I thought. It is a glycolacin IR tablet, like a profile A, profile B. There are different group of tablets or information. Convolution approach, we can able to say slope or regression correlation. We can able to see the regression correlation is better or it is good in deconvolution method than convolution method. That's what we can able to observe from here. No, that's what if you say virtual GLK dissolution profile, this is a normal one. Then when you are compared to the corresponding in vivo correlation, which is more similar than the virtual one. That's what we can say, like the in vivo data is correct when compared to the predicted one. No, that's what it says about dissolved one, the amount of plasma present in the in vivo data. That in vivo in vitro in vivo correlation plot of glycolacid IR tablet, that's what we can able to say, like you can see convolution method have lot of scattering values. In deconvolution method could be able to get a very clear correlation, and this will be better to identify the amount of in vitro correlation have been observed. These results were accordance to the those obtained by convolution approach. Since both convolution deconvolution approach were successfully established level of in vitro in vivo correlation, it is suggested that dissolution specification of more than 85% glycolacid dose dissolved in 60 minutes may be considered as biorelevant dissolution acceptance criteria of glycolacid immediate release tablets. Coming to the next example, or the content is in bioweaver consideration. The role of bioweaver is in the drug approval process. Since it is introduced in 1995, biopharmaceutical classification of the drug, that it is very important to have contract stories of drug, like whether it is we do use for BCS 1 and 3 for immediate release, BCS 4 for sustained release. This was a contradictory things were there. Still now that all the anti-cancer drugs are mostly which is belong to BCS 4, which gives you very, what you can say, an irrational way of improving or the coming to the keeping in the practical aspects is very, very tough. Still, it is a big challenging thing. So this still now these are the considerations to be developed, that it has been done by the USFDA, that in vivo bioavailability or bioequivalent studies of USFDA first release. Situation in which in vivo bioequivalent studies can be submitted with the relevant in vitro data. When adopting the bioweaver concept, was to reduce the time and cost. No, like whether exactly we can able to predict the level of limit, no criteria level, we can able to say whether the product exactly will be meeting the specification, whether it is immediate release, sustained release, or controlled release. It has to be logical or should have proof of concept to understand whether exactly the drug is given as a dosage form. No, the most common type of bioweaver adopt, regulatory authorities included the application BCS-based. That's what it is, very, very basic tendency or should have knowledge, biopharmaceutical classification. It is again big question mark. There are a lot of other loopholes are there. But according to your consideration of examination point of view, to understand some basic thing, similar or rapid or very rapid dissolution profile test reference to the pH 1.2, 4.5, and 6.8 should be addressed. The bioweaver for immediate release may be requested solely in case of highly soluble and highly permeable substances. That's what BCS class 1. It is very, very tough because you can say already it is drug is having BCS class 1. You cannot expect that the drug is, you are doing some other new innovative things to release the drug immediately. That too, that's what you say, like when you are developing a generic drugs. No, that's what it gives you profile of reference. So, product. Coming to the European Medical Association and WHO, agency, no, European Medical Agency or WHO issued guideline widen the eligibility waiver for some of the class 3, very particularly rapid dissolving, like European Medical Agency 2010. Then WHO Expert Committee specifications of pharmaceutical preparation 2006. The BCS class 2 drug is bioweaver consideration of dose to solubility ratio at a specific pH. In terms of this, I want to keep a point. BCS2 can be made it into the suspensions or in-situ gels or hydrogels can improve plenty, or in other terms of what you can say, the dosage forms such as lipophilic or you can say like solid lipid nanoparticle or solid lipid microparticle or lipid vesicles can improve plenty of fold in drug absorption. So there may be possibility to have a route of delivery or to module the design of any kind of a BCS class, but it should supposed to have a very specific layout what kind of design to be done for a formulation to make into the bioweaver consideration limits. And then that's what it should be saying. That recent what update what I found from Indian regulation about the what you can say albendazole. No, albendazole have been revised in the December 2019. Before it was not much, even normal tablet, everything was available. Then 2005 only the world pharmacopoeia is given, international pharmacopoeia is given specification. Some of the other pharmacopoeia also limited to have minimum 90% release by half an hour. The simple dissolution profile calculation have been given. The bioweaver consideration very strict. They made very, very clear instruction that the drug should have been absorbed not less than 85%. That's the same limit. But for the in-house specification for company manufacturings, people is tend to have minimum of 90 to 95% of the drug should be absorbed in such a way the formulations to be manufactured. That is one of the challenging things which is going on relevant to the bioweaver consideration. Coming to the example, like simulation results demonstrated that differences in glycolacid in Divintro dissolution, 85% of the drug dissolved in 15 to 60 minutes time frame are not expected to reflect on in vivo pharmacokinetic profile because it is a physical property. But when come to the crossing the membrane or going to the target site or any physiological condition, cannot be able to predict. That's what in these results support the assumption that in the case of BCS2 drugs, complete in vivo dissolution might occur at a later point of than the highly soluble BCS1. This would allow wider biorelevant or in vitro dissolution specification than very rapid or rapid in vitro dissolution profiles. Even there are different kind of dissolution asset also have been explained to do this kind of bioweaver consideration. To be a set in addition, the in vitro results indicated in glycolacin solubility and the dissolution. Then from the consideration of immediate release tablets are not expected to be a rate limiting factor for GLK in vivo absorption. And since it was highly permeable drug, there was a rationale to postulate that bioweaver extension may be applicable in terms of immediate release tablet. That's what it says about. We can say like we can use for bioweaver extension consideration application. The example two, which is described in 2009 by using a gastroplus again in order to bioweaver of ettoric oxide. That is a contrast. It is in BCS class two. This concept is which is derived from in vitro cell line study CaCO2 to assess drug permeability, but it is maybe compared to animal pharmacokinetic data and clinical data, in vitro people says it is having specific to develop a new dosage form is okay, but the scientists have been trying to convince the regulatory authorities to explain the stage. That's what the things were happened for IR ettoric oxime because it is BCS2. No, the simulation of result revealed that the drug absorption after tablet admission is similar to the absorption of oral absorption, fast and complete drug absorption. Furthermore, the solubility results indicated ettoric oxime became BCS class 1 drug in the acidic environment. The dissolution transfer model confirmed that. It says about solution transfer from acidic environment of the stomach into the small intestine. Therefore, it was concluded that ettoric oxide might be suitable candidate for bioweaver consideration. That is depends upon simple physical solubility character. Then next example, BCS3. Which is the investigated ability of predict BCS1 propranolol, metoprolol, that BCS class 3, then cimetidine, atenolol, and amoxicillin. The performed in vitro bioequivalent studies have been estimated feasibility to extending bioweaver consideration for BCS class 3 drugs. No, In addition to this, the significance of rapid dissolution or very rapid dissolution criteria were also was established or conducted. When you observe the results, the search set of virtual in vitro dissolution data used to input function of predicted model, the predicted PK profile of each BCS3 class of drug, virtual trial, 500 subjects have been taken, and with T 85% of 15 minutes and virtual 24 subjects, the different relevant rates have been respectively observed with respect to the reference and the sample. The results of the prediction Cmax, AUC with the difference of release tablet used in the samples were compared with the reference results. The determined bioequivalence studies, the results demonstrated that the bioequivalence is up to 85% of time within 45 minutes. Amoxicillin 85, which is within 60 minutes in cimetidine and atenolol, compared to the reference result of T 85% 15 minutes of bioequivalence study between very rapid 85% solubility in 15 minutes. It stays out very coinciding the values, which is expected one. That's what we can able to say, the rapid dissolution solubility within 30 minutes. These findings indicated that the permeability of BCS3 compounds was the rate limiting step for the oral drug. According to the results by the BCS class 3 drug, absorption of the drug rather than dissolution, overall obtained result suggested that extending of bioavailability, including the immediate release dosage form, BCS class 3 drug product also is feasible. Moreover, that bioavailability for BCS3 drug product with suitably rapid dissolution would ensure bioperformance of this biopharmaceutical product or pharmaceutical product. Okay, that's what little I went up very fast. I could think you can able to read bioavailability consideration. Very simple. What I want to say from recap from last I'll move, that bioavailability consideration means what? You are using a theoretical value or literature data of same parameter, and what you are getting observed value of in vivo data, in vitro data. You need to correlate what exactly it is happened, or you need to explain what is the exact theory happened. The next example, like in CaCO2, that is for ettoric oxide for BCS2 drug, actually it is a water insoluble drug. Coxibs, ettoric oxibs, but even that it is given, since it in acidic condition, it gives you very good BCS1, then it may be considered like that, it is justifying. The matter of justification is very, very important. When coming to the glycolysins, which is only solubility is the issue, the permeability is high, then you can consider class 1 is also considered for bioavailability consideration. Okay, coming to the what you can say, in vitro in vivo correlation, compulsory need to write about what? Convulsion method, deconvulsion method. Then coming to the what you can say, feed and fast example, like parameter, this table better to prepare, you can able to observe the data what you need to explain. Then you can say like virtual trial in the sense comparing the literature data with an better insight with the current data or your practical data, or you can say like a prediction data. That's what it is given. Okay, today we have seen about virtual trial, feed state, faster feed and fast state, in vitro dissolution, and in vitro in vivo correlation, bioavailability consideration. I think so. No, then next other things we'll see later, and then after this one we'll have that discussion. Thank you.